The occipital bone is bordered by the lambdoidal suture on its most northern portion. This skull is on its side right now, so this is still its most northern point. The occipital bone on its exterior side, on its exterior near the base of the skull, has this little bony protrusion. This is called your external occipital protuberance. So if you rub the base of your head, that little pokey kind of growth you feel, that is going to be this structure right here. On some people, it's a little more pronounced than others. If you rub the back of your head right now, you'll definitely feel it. If we go to the base of the skull, which is still considered the occipital bone goes all the way around through here, you're going to see two condyles. These are going to be called your occipital condyles. Now let me go on this skull right here. If we go on this skull right here, your occipital condyles are a little more visible. They're right here. Then we're gonna have your foramen magnum. Your foramen magnum is this giant hole right here. It's a little bit of the name. Foramen, letting you know a hole, and magnum, it's quite obviously the largest hole on the skull. It is gonna be where your spinal cord comes through. You have your hypoglossal canal, and to show you that, I put that gold chenille through it so it's easier to see. You have two, and obviously your body mirrors on its side, right, the left and right. That's why I have it, so that you can see it on both the left and right. To see it internally, we're going to go ahead and flip the skull over, and there it is, right down there. On the right, here it is on the left. Let me get that to actually zoom in a little prettier. My phone's not in love with this right now. But those are going to be the major features that we want you to know for the occipital bone. Just to let you know, the occipital bone is bordered on the north by the parietal. It is on its east and west by the temporal, and the sphenoid on its most southern border.